Hello and welcome to the second lesson of our free course, which is focused on automated trading. Today's lesson will be very practical, but first of all, we have to take two important steps. I will tell you what market we'll be building a strategy for and why. And in the second step, I will show you how to download and run the StrategyQuant software so you can start building strategies. So let's start with step number one. What markets we'll be building strategies for? StrategyQuant, the software we'll be working with, can build strategies for pretty much any market. In this course, however, we'll be looking at stock indexes. Why? They have long history and long-term direction. Stock indexes are rising over the long term, which is an advantage for us. It allows us to build better and more stable strategies that will give us better profits in the long run. We'll have the history since 2009, and even if the occasional correction comes, as you can see here in the last part of this chart, we have no doubt that the market will rise again. Another reason is the fact that you can find really, really stable strategies for stock indexes. Here you can see an example of a completely random strategy and what it might look like, for example. And you can see for yourself that even in 2022, when the market is in a fairly significant correction, let's be honest, the automated trading strategies built for stock indexes are profitable. What you see here now is a so-called backtest. Simply, if we had started trading this strategy in 2009, our profit would have looked exactly like this, and we would have made about $250,000 of profit. In 2022, it would be $37,000. In 2021, it would be $46,000, and so on. And we'll find out that this is how the strategy would have behaved just from the backtest. So, a backtest is a simulation of the past behavior of a given strategy performed on historical data. To perform a good and relevant backtest, we need two things: good, high-quality 1-minute data and software that can perform a quality backtest. StrategyQuant provides all of this. We explain what types of data exist and how exactly they work in detail in the follow-up course, which is generally much more detailed. But this course is mainly focused on practice, so let's get to it. First of all, you need to download and install the StrategyQuant software. So go to the link in the description, scroll down a bit and click on the download button. Size of the file is about 1 GB because it contains all the history data you need. It's also the reason why the software can't run on cloud but must be downloaded to your device. The average computer or laptop will not have the slightest problem with the software. It doesn't even matter what operating system you use. But I will show you the procedure for Windows in this video. But there are videos in the course on how to install StrategyQuant on Mac or Linux as well. Of course, these always include a link to download StrategyQuant for the relevant operating system. So, we need to download the installation package. Once it's downloaded, we simply unzip it or extract it. To do this, you can use the software for this, for example, WinRAR, or just right-click on the file and select extract all, or simply copy the folder from the zip file to a new location on your computer. After extracting the package, you can safely delete the original zip file, or you don't have to, it's up to you. Now, this action may take some time because, as I said, it's quite large. Once it's done, open the folder and double-click to StrategyQuant X to launch it. If you see a security warning window from Windows on the screen, don't worry, confirm it. The software is properly and officially secured. You can usually wait a while for the first run. So let's wait. And just for you to know, the license is in your email along with a notification about this lesson. And if you still can't find it, simply send us an email. Now we'll wait for the lunch and then I will quickly show you the environment, the data and the strategy so we can start the actual strategy building in the next lesson. Before StrategyQuant launches, I have one small warning for you. Since StrategyQuant uses artificial intelligence and quite a lot of data, it can give your computer quite a workload. Therefore, we recommend a little bit more powerful computer or laptop and run the testing and strategy building and searching preferably overnight when you don't need to use your computer. We will assume that you already have StrategyQuant installed and you just need to import the data. So now let's look at how to download and extract the configuration file. You can find the files at this link where you download them, save them to disk, and display them in the directory where you save them. Now you need to extract the files. You can use, as I do, WinRAR or File Explorer. When we have the files ready, we can switch to StrategyQuant. Since I already have some data here, I'm going to delete it all first so I can show you the complete import process. I'm going to mark all the strategies and click the Mass Delete button. This will delete all the symbols I have imported so far. I will do the same with the instruments. So go to the tab Instruments, select all the data and Mass Delete. Now we have a perfectly prepared environment. So let's move back to the Data tab and here we need to click on the Load icon from the top menu. Now I will find the directory where I save the configuration files, select the data file and confirm the selection. Within a few seconds, the data including the instruments are imported. If for any reason the instruments happen not to be imported, go to the Instruments tab, click on the Load icon again, and select the second file called Instruments from the appropriate directory. We have the data ready and all we need to do is update it. So I will mark all the items, all the symbols, and simply click on Update All. This will take a while. Of course, it always depends on your computer performance, internet connection speed, and data volume. If we were only updating a few selected symbols, it would take much less time. And this will apply at all times. If we update everything, we select all the symbols and click Update All. If we only update selected symbols, we select them and select Update Selected. In this case, I estimate that it will take approximately 30 minutes. We will be most interested in the Builder tab, where we build the strategies. For a very quick demonstration of what the building process looks like, I will click on the Start button in the top menu. By default, StrategyQuant has certain parameters set to build the strategies it will now use. The strategies will start appearing in the section after some time. It will take a while, of course, the software also needs time to kind of warm up and start looking for strategies. These tabs are called data banks, and the only one we are interested in is the results data bank. This data bank will store strategies that match the specified parameters, have good results, and are potentially interesting to us. I will show you how to work with the other elements and tabs you see here during the next lessons. Since I already have the first few strategies here, I will stop generating them now. When I open any strategy, for example, this one, you can see that there's a lot of information about it, from number of trades, to return drawdown ratio, to drawdown, and much, much more. There is really plenty of information. But what's really interesting and important, and I would like to mention it now, and also do not worry if you don't understand it on the first try, is the tab called source code. By selecting pseudocode as the source code type, we are able to see, and believe me, it's not too hard, exactly how the strategy works, based on what inputs, outputs, or what risks the strategy works with. So it is not a black box, so to speak. You know exactly what is happening, how, and why the strategy does what it does. Of course, the strategies are also there in other code types so that you can run it in MetaTrader, for example, or TradeStation, so that you can start trading the strategy in a demo or a test account. We will show you how to set up a demo account and deploy a strategy to it at the end of this course. This will allow you to see how the strategies behave in a real environment. You will be able to follow the development without risking your real money. And that's all for today's lesson. Please remember that we are here for you, so if you have any questions, feel free to contact us. I look forward to the next lesson.